Welcome to On Media. I'm your host, Max Clausen, and today we brought in a panel to talk about the differences between our generation and the older generations regarding media. Let's meet our panel.
Hi, I'm Kyle. I interviewed my dad. His age is 48.
I'm Emma. I interviewed my grandma, and she's 68.
Hi, I'm Luke. I interviewed my mom, and she's 44.
Tell me about your interviewees' responses about their use of media when they were a kid, whether it's TV in the family home, one that they all watched, or a daily newspaper. For example, my grandma said that although they had a TV in their house growing up, they never really sat around and watched TV, only occasionally watched the half-hour sitcoms that were on. She mostly played outside.
My dad also had a TV. He used basically newspapers and magazines to entertain himself and his siblings.
My grandma grew up with one TV in the house. It only had three channels, and it was black and white. She said that they really didn't watch much TV, though, really only the news, and that was mostly at night all together as a family.
Yeah, same thing with my mom. They had one TV in the house, and then they'd gather together sometimes to turn on the nightly news, and they'd all watch it together as a family.
The next question is do they remember getting their first computer or a computer in the family home, and what was that experience like?
My dad got his first computer when he was a teenager. He wasn't really allowed to use it. It was more of an adult thing. But he also stated that at that time, if you had a computer like in your neighborhood, you were labeled as a cool kid because not a lot of people had them.
My grandma got her first computer in 95, and she said she got it because my dad and my aunt had been using them in high school, and so they kind of convinced her to get one. But she told me she does not remember how, she could not figure out how to turn it on when they first got it.
Same with Kyle. My mom said that in the neighborhood, if you were the one with the computer, you were the cool family. But my parents, or my mom was from an immigrant family, so they didn't have money for a computer until later. So they never really labeled the cool parents or kids until college.
Connie said her first computer in the family home was more of a modern typewriter. It could really only process words similar to Microsoft Word can, and the only function it had was to be able to print. She did say later in the early 2000s, she said they did eventually get a computer. She also did say that she thinks the younger generation is missing out on certain aspects of traditional family connections and interactions due to the reliance on smartphones and the internet. She says this is because there is less face-to-face communication and more time spent on devices, which can reduce quality family time and outdoor activities. Do your interviewees also think this, or do they have opposing views?
My dad said it was kind of like a double-edged sword, so there's pros and cons to it. But he said people are missing out on the human interactions. He said when he was younger, he would play outside all day and wouldn't come back inside until his curfew.
My grandma said that she thinks we are missing out on having connections with other people. She said that they used to have face-to-face conversations, and that's something we really don't have to do anymore because of social media and our smartphones. But
yeah, I agree. I think my mom told us that when you aren't interacting with people face-to-face, you really lose the ability to be good at doing that because it's practice makes perfect, right? Because if you're constantly texting someone, there's no tone, there's no inflection, there's no body language, and you really don't learn how to use those skills, which makes your communication less effective in person.
Do any of your interviewees remember getting their first smartphone? What was that like, and how do they think the smartphone impacts their daily life now?
My dad got his first phone freshman year of college, but when he got his first smartphone, he was astonished on what you could do compared to his other phone, how you could text now, use social media apps, get the news on the phone, basically having a handheld computer right in his hand.
My grandma got her first smartphone in 2010. She said it was a big adjustment going from what she was used to such a new technology. And she frequently had to ask my dad for help on how to figure out how to work it.
My mom got her first smartphone in college. She had to figure out how to navigate all that.
Connie said she really only got her first smartphone in the later 2010s, and her views on it have only just started to change. She says while it offers convenience and access to information, we can spend too much time on it, and learning to control the usage is important. My views have really stayed the same about media and technology. I've always seen the benefits of it, but I also know how the older generation feels about it. Although they think we need to control our usage of it and it takes away our connections, I argue that we are more connected today than ever before. What are your opinions on media and have your perspectives changed?
My perspectives have not changed. I still think it's a benefit to society. I just think people get glued to their technology too much.
I think technology has more advantages than disadvantages, and I'd say that my perspectives really haven't changed with this interview, but I think it was nice to get a viewpoint from an older generation and see how they view us.
When I talked to my mom about it, she isn't really exposed to like social media apps like Snapchat or Instagram that often, or she just uses it to check up on people, but I feel like she doesn't really have a perspective of how kids use it. So she thinks it's all, you know, great stuff. And I would like to like rescind my last statement with the smartphone thing. I was thinking about a flip phone when she got her first flip phone, not smartphone.
All right, well, that is all the questions we have for our panelists today. These are all amazing points and really show the differences between our generation and the older generations. Thank you for tuning into On Media and have a good one.